Hi, Rambo here of Rambo and Joanne Vlog. Sa video na to, you will not be seeing Joanne dahil I'll be sharing with you a portion of a training kung saan I was invited to speak sa mga 18 to 30 years old na mga single. Kung saan I spoke about self-worth and how important each of us are in this grand scheme of life. Though yung second half ng training na yon, I will not be sharing it with you here. Kasi I wanted to do that with Joanne with you sa mga next namin na bedroom talks. So without further ado, here's that part of the training. Cheers!
Bedroom talk!
Bedroom talk!
Kahit na nafifade ka, you are getting one step closer.
Now, sa time natin kanina, nagkaroon tayo ng chance to get to know each other. Kung ipakilala sa inyo yung someone din. Someone na sa tingin ko ay worth din ng time nyo na makilala. Narinig nyo na ba yung pangalan na ito? Rembrandt? Rembrandt is an artist. He is a painter. Kasama siya doon sa top list ng mga painters natin. Siya ay nung 1600s pa lang, namamayagpag na siya. Kasama niya to sila Da Vinci, yung mga top names na yan. Sila Picasso. Ganun siya ka-well-known. Mind you, si Rembrandt ay isa sa mga important person sa pagdating sa larangan ng arts, at least sa Dutch, as far as Dutch people are concerned. This is him doing a selfie. This is not a painting, this is a scribble. This is him who painted himself. I imagine kung gaano ka-skilled you must be, that person must be, para magawa niya yung bagay na yan. That's how good he is. Kaya niyang gawin yung bagay na to. And here are some of the paintings na probably na-encounter nyo na. Sa kaliwa, ito yung crucifixion ng ating Savior Jesus Christ. Sa kanan naman, ito yung tungkol sa prodigal son. The return of the prodigal son, to be exact. Now, alam nyo ba na kahit 1600s pa si Rembrandt, up to this very moment na 2021 na, people are still finding him interesting at yung kanyang mga paintings, kanyang mga obra. A couple of years ago, one of his paintings was sold for $33.2 million. Kung isipin mo, di ba, who in the right mind will be willing to pay that much money for a painting? And probably you might say na, sige, yung mga tao na may pera. Well, yung next question ko, kung may pera ka, gagamitin mo ba yun para bumili ng ganito kamahal na painting? And just this year, 2021, nung February, sinimulan yung auction sa painting na to. Ito ay si Abraham kasama ang isang angel. At sinimulan yung auction na yan sa $20 million. And guess how much ito na sold? It was sold for $92.2 million. This was on February 2021. In the middle of pandemic, akala natin walang pera yung mga tao. Pero here are a group of people willing to pay this much. Now, again, you may be wondering who on their right mind would pay someone para sa ganitong uri ng mga bagay. Well, maraming mga possible reasons why. And a study shows, ito yung top reasons bakit willing magbayad yung mga tao ng ganun kamahal for paintings na lumang-luma na. And this is not in order, pero yung isang reason is because of the uniqueness. Yung painting ng mga tao na to, kagaya ni Rembrandt, sila Michelangelo din yung kanilang mga sculpture, ay unique. Hindi yun nauulit, isa lang siya. So kung nasa iyo yung isang kopya na to, sa iyo lang siya. Wala tong katulad. And the other reason is dahil sa pangalan ng painter. Pagka nakuha nila to, alam nila na, oh, kaling to kay Rembrandt, siya yung nagpaint nito. These are the top reasons bakit willing yung mga tao na magbayad ng ganitong halaga. Well, here's the first lesson for you all, my young friends. And I want you to take note of this. Please take note of this. Yung painting na Rembrandt is not as worth as yourself. Your worth is a lot greater and more expensive than any of Rembrandt's painting. Ulitin ko, your worth is a lot greater and more expensive than any of Rembrandt's painting. Kahit pagsamahin mo yung mga painting din nila Leonardo da Vinci, pagsamasamahin mo na yung mga yon, mas mahal ka. And probably for these two reasons then. One is because you are unique. Nag-iisa ka lang. Walang kadulad mo. Meron kang mako-contribute na ikaw lang ang pwedeng mag-contribute noon. Meron kang magagawa na ikaw lang yung pwedeng gumawa. Ikaw lang yung nag-iisang pwedeng magmahal sa nanay mo or sa tatay mo ng kagaya ng pagmamahal na meron ka. Now, gusto kong hilingin sa inyo na humarap ka sa katabi mo, sabi mo sa kanya, ang unique-unique mo. You are unique in every way. And another reason kung bakit mas expensive ka at mas worth ang kaluluwa mo kaysa sa mga paintings na Rembrandt is because of the master painter himself. Even the creator of the universe, of this earth, of everything we see. He painted you. He created you. My young friends, every time na may mga things na nangyayari sa'yo and you feel na you are worthless, please remember these two things. One is you are unique, nag-iisa ka, walang kagaya mo, walang ibang Samuel Damasco Mina, nag-iisa ka lang. Walang Edmer Gamilla na iba maliban sa'yo. At yung kaya mong i-offer ay ikaw lang yung meron nun. And then number two na sana maalala natin na you were created by the master creator, the master painter. Knowing this will change everything. It will change the way we see things. It will change the future para sa atin. It will change the now. Here is a short clip from then President Utdorf, now an elder, pushing more yung idea na to na yung worth mo ay far expensive than Rembrandt's painting. So please take note.
God has given again in these latter days the truth about where we came from, why we're here, and where we are going. Much of the confusion we experience in this life comes from simply not understanding who we are. One of the most beloved storytellers of all time was the Danish writer Hans Christian Andersen. In one of his stories, The Ugly Duckling, a mother duck discovers that one of her newly hatched chicks is unusually large and very ugly. The other ducklings cannot leave the ugly child alone. They punish him mercilessly. The ugly duckling decides it would be better for everyone if he left his family, and so he ran away. Then one day, he sees flying overhead a flock of majestic birds. He takes flight and follows them to a beautiful lake. The ugly duckling looks into the water and sees a reflection of a magnificent swan. The ugly duckling realizes that the reflection is his own. He has discovered who he really is. Think of where you come from. You are sons and daughters of the greatest, most glorious being in the universe. He loves you with an infinite love. He wants the best for you. This knowledge changes everything. It changes your present, it can change your future, and it can change the world. If only we understood who we are and what is in store for us, our hearts would overflow with such gratitude and happiness that it would enlighten even the darkest souls with the light and love of God. Of course, there will always be voices telling you that you are foolish to believe that you are swans, insisting that you are but ugly ducklings and that you can't expect to become anything else. But you know better. You are no ordinary beings. You are glorious and eternal. I plead with you, just look into the water and see your true reflection. It is my prayer and blessing that when you look at your reflection, you will be able to see beyond imperfections and self-doubts and recognize who you truly are, glorious sons and daughters of Almighty God. In the sacred name of Jesus Christ.
Sabi niya, there will be voices, di ba, who will tell you otherwise. Pero please know that you are precious to Him. And how precious are you? Well, He gave His life. He gave His life for you. Sometimes yung mga voices na yon, yun yung nakikita natin sa social media, yun yung opinion ng iba, yun yung mga trash talk na natatanggap nyo minsan sa paglalaro ng online games, or minsan yung mga naririnig mo lang kung saan saan. Pero one thing is for sure, yung worth mo ay napakahalaga at mas mahal ka kaysa sa painting ni Rembrandt. Now, here's my take, and this is from me to you. Number one, since nalaman mo na your worth is far greater than any paintings, I want you to know this thing too. The same is true about other people. Wow, surprise! Kung anak ka pala ng Diyos, well, others are anak niya rin. Including those na medyo hindi mo type. Anak din siya ng Diyos. What does that mean? Kung ano yung gusto mong mangyayari sa'yo na magaganda, di ba? Somehow, we will do the same for others. We will have them experience the same things. If we want to be lifted, then we will lift others. Another thing from me to you, mula sa lesson na to, is to demand progress from yourself. Interestingly, the word demand, we use it most of the time towards others. Like, we demand respect, di ba? We demand a better service sa mga hospitals or sa mga kainan. Yeah. We demand a better internet connection. Pero we seldom do this. We seldom demand things from ourselves. We demand people to change, pero we don't demand change within us. Young friends, now that you know, and I hope you already know this long time ago, na you are important at great ang soul mo, please know that others are great as well. And I want to focus the rest of my time on this number two. Demand progress from yourself. This is not gonna be comfortable, sigurado yan. Kasi progress is not comfortable. Pero progress is always worth it. And progress is what Heavenly Father wants for us. Do you remember the parable of the talent? Do you remember how the Lord praised dun sa dalawa? Sinabi niya na, thou good and faithful servants. How do you think we will progress? Ano yung mga pwede natin gawin to progress?
Alright, as I said kanina sa introduction, I wanted to give you the second part of it as a bedroom talk kasama si Joanne without the slides and all. Alright, cheers for being here. Salamat. Till next video. Bye.